Hello and welcome to the applicant check-in form at Microverse. My name is Tina, I am the applicant success lead, and I might be one of the people that look at your submission when you have completed this form. There are two things that we need to know before we start filling out this form. Number one, you need to do it from a computer. This is a non-negotiable. You need to have a computer to continue to the next step in the application. And if you're not on your computer now, I recommend you put your phone down or your tablet and you move to your computer now. The other thing to know is that there are two very common reasons we see for declining a check-in form the first time around. And it is that the microphone quality in the recording that we ask of you is really bad, or the internet speed that you submitted or the stability of that internet speed was not really great. And I'll talk you through some of the requirements as we go along in the form. But I recommend that you check these things before you submit anything to make sure that you're not delaying your application due to not making this work for you already. So, in case you have any questions as you go through the form, please do email us at admissions@microverse.org. We are literally employed to help you, so do not hesitate to send us an email at any given point. Are you ready? Okay. Number one, what is your name? This is the easiest question to ask, I'll be honest. However, you need to make sure that your name correlates with the email address, because you may share your full name with someone else, but you would not share the email address with them also. So for me, my name is Tina Green, and this is my email address, but there is another person named Tina Green with a different one. I just need to make sure I select the correct one. Otherwise, I would be submitting the form on behalf of someone else, and that would not be very nice. The next question is, the whole point of submitting this form is for you to progress to the Microverse Trials. In the Microverse Trials, you'll be meeting with three other applicants that are also looking to join Microverse for 4 hours per person. So you would spend 12 hours in the next week after submitting this form collaborating with these people. That means you have to have 12 extra hours available to do this, okay? So if you're not ready, or if you're like, you'll be traveling for the next week or have a super stressful week at work coming up, then please wait with submitting the form until you are available to meet the other people that are also trying to get accepted to Microverse. The next question that we have, I'll just check this box. The next question that we have is, which schedule do you want to study in? And this is, it might seem like a small question now, but it's actually a very important one, because what you select here today will be the schedule that you will go into the full-time program with. So make sure that you are choosing a schedule that you will be able to sustain for 10 months. It's not temporary, it's not a small commitment. You are committing to a specific schedule, an attendance policy, and a whole bunch of other things by selecting your schedule now. So to make sure that you're choosing what is the most comfortable one for you, you need to understand the difference in commitments for you depending on the schedule that you choose. So the two schedules that we offer is a UTC minus 6, which is almost exclusively for the American continent, whereas UTC plus 1 is the most suitable one for Europe, Africa, and Asia. And I'll illustrate the difference that you might experience in the program depending on your location and the schedule that you choose now. Number one, in case you are currently in Lagos, for example, in Nigeria, and you want to study in UTC minus 6, that means you would start your day at 3 p.m., right? That's pretty late and might not be the ideal time for most people to start their full-time kind of commitment on. So that also means you would be ending your day at 5:15, you'd see minus 6, which is after midnight in Lagos. That is maybe not ideal. However, it might not seem terrible. In case you are in Nigeria, that seems like you could sustain that. However, if you are in New Delhi, that means you would be ending your day at 4:45 a.m., which is incredibly late, or early, depending on how you think about it. So, in case you are in New Delhi, then I would definitely not recommend that you select this time zone. Because if we look at how your hours would look in UTC plus one, comparatively, that means you would start your day at 12:30 during the day, right? And you would finish your day, oh, excuse me, you would finish your day at 5:15 UTC plus one, which is also just before, late evening. So 9:45, you would finish your day. You still have some time left in the evening to watch a movie or go to bed after a long day. So for someone in New Delhi, I would recommend going into the UTC plus one time zone, as well as if you are in Lagos, I would still also recommend that you go into UTC plus one. However, if you are based in Peru, then I would recommend that you select the UTC minus six time zone because that is much more closely correlated to your personal time zone, which is UTC minus five, right? So only a 1 hour difference there. And that is how you would be using these two links to actually convert our schedules with your specific time zone. In case you choose a schedule that is not the closest match to your daytime, then we expect you to explain what your previous experiences are that tell you that you would be able to sustain the schedule for 10 months' time. And it's really important that you're able to explain yourself well here. So don't skip this form, or this field, because we will ask you for more information in case we see that you have selected an opposing schedule, right? And you can see that example here. All right, that's it on your schedules. Number two, or not number two, but coming up are two different internet tests that we're going to ask you to do. And to get this out of the way now, we have very specific measurements that are the minimum acceptable ones for you to move on to the next stage of your application. Those are listed here. So the link is in the form. You can have a look at it anytime. Here are the requirements. So we are looking for all of our applicants to have a download speed above 3 megabit per second, an upload speed above 1 megabit per second, jitter below 30 milliseconds, ping latency below 150 milliseconds, and a packet loss equal to 1% or lower. In case your results do not meet those requirements, your application will not be moved further, right? So, we are asking you to check by going to this link. This is test number one. You arrive on this page and you just hit go. I will pause as I do this because it's a waste of time for you to look at this. Perfect. So, these are my results. I have a download speed of 7 megabit per second, upload speed of 7.6, jitter of 1 millisecond and ping of 12 milliseconds. So this is above 3, this is above 1, this is below 30, and this is below 150, right? I am fine. I will click this copy link button that's here, and I will go back to my form and I will paste that link in here. So when you submit this form, I'll be able to click on the link and I'll be able to see the outcome of your test. Next up is sending us a screenshot of your packet loss. And this one you do via the terminal on your computer, right? So I'm on a Mac. I will be copying this text and I will be opening my terminal and I will be just pasting this in and I hit enter and now I will wait. It will take maybe 2 minutes for this to run through, so let me pause. All right, so my packet loss test has been completed. I can see here at the bottom that I had a 1% packet loss, which is acceptable since that is the maximum allowed packet loss I am allowed to have at Microverse. So what we're gonna do is take a screenshot of this packet loss, just making sure that this bottom section is included. And then we're going back to the form and we are going to upload it here. Easy peasy. We hit attach file, We select file to upload. And there we go. We open that one and upload. Perfect. So if your connection meets our standards as per this article, then you check the box. Here you go. My connection meets the required standards of the program. In case you have submitted information that does not meet these requirements, we will ask you to troubleshoot until the point that it does. In case you cannot make your connection meet these requirements using, for example, an Ethernet cable or upgrading your software, whatever, then we will ask you to actually pay to get either a better machine or upgrade your internet connection with your internet service provider. Those are the only two options we really have in case your connection does not meet our requirements. So make sure that you do as much as you can to facilitate a stable internet connection where you live. Next up is for you to record a video of you talking about yourself for 2 minutes. I know that can be super intimidating, but keep in mind that in the program, you will be spending 8 hours per day with other people on video calls. So if you can get familiar recording yourself now and seeing yourself on the screen and just communicating with no particular goal, then now is as good as time as any. And we are not judging you by any means when we receive your video. We just want to make sure that you can verbally communicate with us and that your English levels, now verbal English, is understandable to some degree. Otherwise, we will send you feedback to say, hey, maybe you need to work on this, or maybe your webcam had some issues, or maybe, again, as I mentioned before, maybe your microphone needs some improvements. So that is what we are expecting here. Normally, the videos that we get at this point, they sound like this. Hello, my name is Tina. I live in Portugal. I am applying to Microverse because I'm really interested in the curriculum. I really wanted to learn web development because of these reasons in my past, where I've always been curious about joining the tech industry. There is no reason that is invalid for you to want to join Microverse. So we just want to hear more about you. How come you want to join us for almost a whole year? And we're just really curious to know more about you. So even though it might be intimidating, please do take the time to send us a nice 2-minute video. You can use Loom, we have a link to that here, but you can also upload your video having been recorded using any tool to YouTube or to Google Drive. Just make sure that when you share the link with us here, that we will have access to view it. So either mark the video unlisted on YouTube and make sure that in case it's on Google Drive, you share it with anyone with the link having permission to view. That's it. The next question, it is about showing us your writing skills. And here we're super adamant about you using Grammarly because it's so important that you are able to make yourself fully understood as you write other people. So knowing full well that like everyone that works at Microverse, our language is not English. Like the primary language of me, I don't speak English. It's not my first language. I use Grammarly religiously, and we expect you to do the same. So as you write your little essay of 150 words, right? Telling us the top 3 reasons we should invest in you, we expect you to use Grammarly. It is incredibly easy to install. It's just a little extension. You can see it up here. Or you can just go to grammarly.com. You open a new document that I will show you now. Here we go. And here we just say, hi, Microverse. Oh, see, look at that. My name is Tina. And you can see, here it is. Correct your spelling. It is the best tool in the world, and I very, very much hope that you will use it. As you complete your text, you paste it into here when you are sure that it is what you want to submit, and you have checked it in Grammarly. Again, it is so important that the text that we receive is well, grammatically well written. So make the extra effort, install the Grammarly extension or use the features on the website. Just make sure that you have checked your content. No matter how confident you are in your English, we will require you to use Grammarly in the program. So you might as well start now. Just paste the text into the box below. Don't send us any links, please. Don't send us any extra documents. Just paste the text in here. And that's all that we need. Afterwards, we expect you to read the code of conduct that comes with Microverse. The code of conduct explains acceptable behaviors, behaviors that we encourage, and behaviors that we don't want to see and do not accept in our students and applicants. So as you can see, we expect everyone to talk using inclusive language. We expect you to be generous in giving and accepting feedback. We expect you to be a kind person to others. We don't want you to harass people due to any reason, be it gender, able-bodiness, religion, nothing, right? So, of course, we want to see you succeed at Microverse. And in case you do have any experience working in diverse teams, in case you have experience with diverse groups of people in general, then you'll know that there are a lot of different people out there and none of them should be harassed, ideally, by you or anyone else. So please read through the code of conduct. It does apply throughout the entire Microverse program. So it is important that you understand what you are committing to in terms of your conduct. And then the last step that we are asking of you is to verify that all the answers that you submit in this form, that they are correct to the best of your knowledge and belief. So don't lie in the form. Like, that is essentially what we're trying to say. In case we do catch you in a lie in this document, then we will not accept you as a Microverse student. So please make sure that you contact us at admissions@microverse.org if you have any questions about how to proceed, so that we do not incorrectly and unfairly prevent you from applying to the program. I think that is a good point to finish on. I'm very much looking forward to receiving your application. Please let me know if you have any questions, and good luck, and have a good day.